This is part 4 of the Espeon. Today going to continue with a couple of stitches on its head and then going to start and finish its whiskers. And this is how it's going to look like at the end of this part. Before going to show you some more points of view, I want to say two things. One is I'm going to split this video into two parts because it gotten pretty long. Two is, if you can, please read the important sections on the descriptions, especially when I came to here on the second half of this video. The left whisker, instead of first continuing here and then cutting the strings over here, I did the opposite. I cut the strings and then you continue. So it was a little mistake, so that's why we have things like that. So let's show you some stuff and then I'm going to start. So front head, back upper head, right whisker, left whisker, and finally the stitch itself. So let's begin. I'm gonna need to make another two stitches of 4x5. So let's make them right now and then we continue with whiskers. So let's put all of these four strings, adding it here. Doing it here. Next, make sure that these two are up here. And weaving all the rest, the right side here. And after that, gonna need to weave all of another four strings, or no, another four strings. Yeah, excuse me, another eight strings. Taking this string here, I'll weave it. Next, taking this one. Now, I'm gonna need to use my scissors. Next, taking here, moving here, and taking these guys, these three strings, getting them through here, up to here. Next, getting back to here, weaving the last one on this side, this one. Right. Next, taking this one, so make sure this is here, and now taking this string, gonna weave this on. So this string, next, okay, next string, this one. Weave a dude. Okay, now pulling the strings. Next, let's do another stitch. So, yeah, let's make another one, last one, and then we'll add the whiskers. Continuing the stuff, the usual stuff. Oops, excuse me. Yeah, taking all these five strings and gonna weave them over under. All this mess, any moment you'll see what I'm talking about. Except this string, I don't know why I even weaved this one. But anyway, you can see that what's all these five strings, you can go over, under at once, making it a little bit faster for weaving. Yeah, and next, going to take this little guy, gonna weave this one. Next, this one. Okay, moving to our side. Taking this string, good. Next, taking, I guess, taking these three and going to weave them at the same time. So make sure it's gonna fall through these guys. It's just a miss, but in a moment we'll be continuing. Okay. Let's think. What's this thing? I don't know why he's here. Okay, looks good. Now I need to take this guy, this string, up to here because I want to make the wire symmetrical. So at the center, the wire is always the center. So I'm just gonna, you see, move it here, and you can see that it's now to our side. So next, taking, okay, I need to take the left strings the last one are the left strings here. So this one. So I'm gonna need to weave it. This wire is annoying. Four, five loops, taking a guy, my string, moving here. And of course, let's see. Yeah, of course, now comes the last two strings. So, taking this one and gonna weave it. So let's do it properly. Nest string to weave this one. Great. Perfect. And yeah, then just need to weave again. And we can continue the main thing that I wanted to show here today. So let's take a look at the Espeon right now. I want to add right now the whiskers of Espeon. The way to do it is to insert a new string for two of the loops here on this side, and inserting another string for two of the two loops here in the right side as well. It's really hard to see which loops to add here, so let's move to the new head, and I want to add on the left side here, I want to add a new string through this loop and this loop. So you can kind of need to take the loop here and want to open it up opening this one up and also this one. So let's first focus on the left side of the head. So again, just making sure, I need to add a string in between these two loops. So let's do it. I have here a new string, and first of all, it's very better to make the string a little bit sharper. And we want to add insert the new string in between the two loops I showed earlier. So this one and this one. So let's start with this one. I want to open it up a little bit. Okay, and taking the new string. Also the new string is 1.5 meters, about 4 feet long. So I'll put it in the description as well. As you can see, I added inside the loop. And next, you just need to pull it a little bit. Okay, next, I want to insert it into the second loop. The second loop is over here, this one. So you can see slowly, we want to add it through the second loop. Now we can pull the string, and you see we have here a new string that is going to stick out over here to make sure that the whisker is also we also need to add a new string in between here, but we need to first find the center of the string. So just moving it a little bit and you continue. So I want to focus right now only on the left side, because the right side is a little bit different. We need to add it in between two different loops. So because it's a symmetrical, it's a whole topic on its own, so let's not discuss things that are not relevant for right now. So let's continue a little bit of a whisker. I think I'll maybe even to finish it. No, maybe to make a few stitches and then to go to the right side. So let's explain here a little bit more. I want to make a 2x1, a break stitch. So make a break stitch, make two break stitches, and then add another, no, make a break stitch here, and then add like another. I got it. You need to make two break stitches, and then it will go over here. That's my idea right now. So how to do it. So we need to insert one string. So this is another new string. It's about half a meter is about 1.5 feet. You want to insert it through the loop that is made right now. We with this string. This, you can see this loop point here. If we open it up a little bit, you can see you can create a loop. And we want to add it full. Inside this loop. So you can see. And what you get is a string inside here. And of course, you need to find the center of a string. Okay, that's good, but we need a break stitch, not a box. You can see here, we can create a box here, but we want to make a break. So we want to add another string. So the other string is this one here down. So we need to think how to do it. And my idea to do it is to first make a box stitch and then add the new string. So, also it's very important to know what direction. So, or starting here, or starting here. There are two options, right? Or here and here, or here and here. So, let's find it out. So, by looking at the stitch, I see that the upper one is on the left side, the down one is on the right side. So you want to make sure this one is here on the left side, and this one is on the right side. Why? Because there is a reason, but it's because of symmetry. And this is the simplest solution for making it symmetric. So just do it. Just make sure that this one, the upper one, is on the left, the down one is on the right. And then you can continue normally. We made the first box. We want to add right now the new string because we want to make it break. So another short string that I have here, a half meter, about 1.5 feet, I think. And you want to add it in between here and here. So, and with that, we can have a break stitch. Make sure it's at the center of a stitch. Okay, just putting it in between here and here. Nothing new. And adding it. Okay, all set and done, I think. Just need to make sure that the string at the center. A little bit here, moving here. Okay, that'll be good. Okay, yeah, this is okay. And pulling the strings. And here we have a first stitch for the whiskers, the left whisker. We can make another stitch and we can go to the right whisker. Okay, after you pull the strings nicely, let's make another one. Let's make another one. Let's move on to the next whisker, because now it's pretty easy to continue. So let's move on to the other side, white side. Now the white side is, as I said before, it's a little bit different because you want to make it symmetrically, and because of symmetry it's hard to predict what to do. So it's just, you need to follow what I did here without really to understand, but so okay, let's think what I did here. I added a full voice one. I'm not sure what I added. Oh, okay, this one is down here. Okay, I know what to do. So coming back to here, we want to add it in between 90% sure. That is in between this one and this one. Okay, in between this loop and this loop to add a new string. It's one last time to make sure that this is fine. So I think I added here. In between this loop. Okay, yeah. So let's do it. We want to add it in between this loop and this loop, so make sure you have a new string. You want to sharpen it a little bit, so let's sharpen it together. Okay, I think that's okay. Let's now add the string. So you want to take it through here. Okay, and add it for the next loop for here. Okay, now this looks nice, and let's take a look one last time here. Okay. So, finding the center of a string. we want to insert another two new strings, half a meter long, to create a break stitch. So our first string, of course, we need to add in between the new loop that we created, this one. So open it up and add it inside. Next, I kind of not sure what to do, because on my previous Espeon, I added a new string on top instead of down. I don't know why, but I think we can make it a little bit better than this one to create the most symmetry we can get. Let's just check here for a second. Okay, the right side, the downside is the right, left side. Okay. So we, in very summary, we want to make sure that on the right side, we want to make sure this one is on the left, and this one is on the right. And why? Because of symmetry. We want to make sure that the symmetry of this one is the same as this one. So in order to do it, we want to make sure it's like that and not the opposite. In fact, I'm not sure why, but maybe even it's not that true, but I'll stick to what I did here. And this is how I did it, I think. So, side. Okay, let's make the box. So we want to make sure that this string here is on the left, this string here is on the right, and we want to add here, making the box stitch here, as you do normally. Now you can see that naturally the strings are more down, more here than here. That's why I added the new string to create the break stitch. I added for here and not downside here. Because if I do it here, it's kinda not nice. It will get here, this big loop. It will stay a big loop, and there is too much space to see. And in short, it's very not nice to see. So on the right side, you want to add the new string, the second string to make the break stitch. You want to add it for here, not for here. Okay? So this is the type of things that you can do it only by knowing, like only by experience. There's not, I did on the first try, I made it here. And then I saw it's not that nice. So I learned from that, and now I know that you need to put it upward here and not like I did in the other side here, that is down here. So I want to add it the second string, that is another half meter, 3 feet long for here. Okay, and And yeah, I need to make sure that the string is at the center. We can create the loops. Okay, and let's make another one. Let's do it fast. Okay, that looks good. Now I'll pause here a little bit because I don't know. Okay, looks good.